Well, Broward officials asking voters to raise taxes next Tuesday. They say it's for a good reason. What they're calling much needed transportation improvements. The plan would bump sales taxes up from 6% to 7% and set a cap. NBC6 political reporter Steve Litz shows us what's on the ballot.
Would you pay a penny for a smoother ride in Broward County traffic? That's what voters are considering. Broward Mayor Beam Ferg getting calls every day.
You know, they're either asking me, what can you do about traffic? You know, it's taking me forever. Or, you know, there's no bus coming to this house. You know, why I had to be 3 hours on a bus? Or the bus was late.
The campaign is called The Penny for Transportation, and the county's website offers explanations and details on the additional 1% sales tax. Project highlights include installing smart signal technology to reduce traffic congestion, reconfiguring 122 bottleneck intersections across the county, improve drainage to reduce flooding, also add about 270 buses, new bus routes, and some 1,400 new bus stops. More expensive items like cars would be subjected to the additional tax, but there is a $5,000 cap per sale. So the maximum additional tax that somebody would pay even on a big ticket item would be $50.
It's not that huge. It's still money. I don't want to demean that, but it's not. It's a fill-up, one fill-up.
The additional tax would be imposed for 30 years. It would generate about $300 million each year, and county officials say the average annual cost to a Broward household would be about $174. Mayor Furr says light rail on major corridors is one component to the plan.
441, University, perhaps Broward, out by the colleges.
On the top, examples of taxable items like eating out, clothing, and appliances. Non-taxable items include groceries, gasoline, and healthcare expenses. If you drive anywhere in South Florida, you probably see a lot of this. Officials in Broward are hoping the estimated $15 billion generated over the next 30 years will calm their traffic. In Broward County, I'm Steve Litz, NBC6 News.